make scenarios, or how to modify scenarios and campaigns so that you can play it with any submarine you wish for. This guide, yeah, as you know, this guide is for sub-command and dangerous waters. I will also explain there are some minor differences, but you can do it for both. Let me first get on my chat in case there are any questions. Sound check. Okay. Yes, as there's the SCX SCU mod for subcommand, and there's a reinforced alert mod for dangerous waters, introducing a lot of new platforms, submarines, and reinforced alert even introducing new aircraft and new surface platforms. And you might be at some point, what you might be thinking the same as I did, that it is great to have so many subs, but it's sometimes difficult to find a good single player mission or situation for it, as there's perhaps not a campaign for the sub you wish to play. I don't know, Australian sub you want to play, or a Chinese sub, but there's no campaign or no single player mission for it. And yeah, there's a workaround which is really quick and allows you to play basically any sub you want. First, about how scenarios or campaigns are handled. Let's check dangerous waters. It's basically the same for sub command. Go into the folder scenario. I have a lot of stuff here. And you will see extensions. MC is basically mission campaign. MU, I don't know what this U stands for. But these are single player missions, and then here MU. There's a third, which I don't find now. Whatever. MC is campaign. MU or this other is something else. Everything that starts with a dot M. That's also missions. So, a campaign. How does a campaign work? Let's check out, for example, earning your something easy, perhaps. Something is numbers. This here, perhaps. What is this? TR1. Okay, let's open my campaign and then a file, but it's not that important. If you open Earning Your Dolphins, this is a campaign file which defines a campaign. You will see a lot of simply linear calling them missions that are belonging to this campaign. Yeah, CR1, CR2, exactly, that's what we was looking for. See here, CR1, CR2, MC, you see mission campaign. And that is basically what appears in your campaign screen. And then you have the single missions here. And yeah, MCs don't appear in single player missions. They only appear and being called by this CAM files, which you can open with a text editor. And single player missions, like I said, are often MU. And here is MS. Not exactly sure what is S. What is the difference between MU, MS? Yeah, but MU appears in campaign screens and whatever. But that's not so important. Just showing this, so if you modify a campaign, let's say you want to modify the Akula campaign that comes with red reinforced alert. Yeah, the Akula Rust campaign, yeah, this here. Then perhaps back up those missions, or simply keep the download around if something goes wrong. You can simply create a backup folder here and put stuff into it. Or simply copy, backup the complete scenario folder. Mine is somewhat big, but normally it's okay. Yeah, for a backup, 300 MB, that's fine. So then start the game, because we will do everything in game. Using a special method to start the game. Okay, yeah, and you will check out here the campaign. There is this reinforced alert conversion of the subcommand campaign. Yeah, okay. And normally I already did some stuff, so no spoilers, but...
Severny Morskoy Flot.
This beginning is always butchering these words, that is great. Yeah, but for example, if you take a normal mission, you normally present it with screens like this, yeah? Where a boat or even a special boat is, for example, here the Miami, is yeah defined for you. You could also change it if, for example, you don't want to run the Miami, or, but the, I don't know, Connecticut or whatever, though I'm not exactly sure what LA classes there exist, but you are really, I don't know, living in a town or a big fan of, or surfed on a specific LA class. This is also possible. And yeah, everything I show is on your own risk, yeah? So I didn't do super extensive testing or whatever. You are all adults, yeah, and tested out. I didn't see any issues. We will talk about some stuff, but yeah. Okay, let's say we want to modify this Russian campaign. It normally plays the Akula 2, and you want to play Akula 3, or even a Borei class, or a Lada class. Or you want to choose your sub every single mission. You want to play a Chinese sub, a British sub, a Indian sub, or perhaps even a US sub. It doesn't make sense, of course, US sub, but whatever. Whatever fits floats your boat, yeah, play what you desire. And here you will go into the mission editor. For single player missions, it's quite straightforward. Let's load a mission. Let's say I wanted, for example, to open up the... There's also a reinforced alert conversion of the 688 campaign, the 688 Hunter Killer game, which is also made by Zoneless, which was released even before Subcommand, before Dangerous Waters and before Subcommand. You open the first mission here, perhaps I already did it. Yeah. You open it up. You will be presented with assets. Don't look perhaps too much at it. I simply just focus on this symbol, this red one here, which is like indicating player sub, as far as I know. It's most times in the upper screen. Press on it. And here you will see your player sub. Here you see LA for whatever class, San Juan. Sure, you could define it by selecting another submarine. But there's even a greater function here, page 2, page 3. Player has choice of platform. And if you hover over it, over the editor, when this option is selected, player can select from any drivable platform to play this mission. Activate it, save. Done. You don't even need to leave the game for it. Let's check out this single player mission. Look at this. Everything you wish for. Everything you wish for. French, Italian, whatever you want. Everything here. Yeah. Next. Now you say, okay, campaign. I noticed in the mission editor my campaign missions are not appearing here. Yeah, that's true. But for this you have a campaign, load campaign mission function. Press on it. Then you have the. You need to select the CAM file I showed you previously. Let's select the Russian one, because the Russians have a lot of submarines with similar capabilities. You perhaps have enough of Akulas, or you want to upgrade to the Akula 3, or you want to make it more challenging, drive the old Akula. You want to drive a Victor, a whatever, a Delta, a Borei, a Lada class. And here, you have a list of the missions that are defined in this campaign file, and you can simply open them up. Again, yeah, only look at this red symbol in order not to spoil it too much yourself, and press on it. Page 3. I already did it. And I will do it now quickly for all, and then we will switch to Subcommand. In Subcommand there is a British campaign, a Falklands campaign, Falkland War campaign. But for some reason it is Seawolf. I would rather like to play a British submarine, yeah, a Trafalgar class or something. So I will switch, because there's a bit, you can do it in both games, but there are some differences that I showed you. For subcommand it is a bit more I forget which one was it now, 3? 4 I guess. Oh no, 3. Yeah, and then simply hit save. Or save it as a different name, but watch out, because I don't know exactly, a campaign, you know, because those campaign missions are defined by name in this text file, so if you switch a name it might not appear. So I save it simply. It was 3, right? Let's mix this 4. Five is done. Ah, yeah, 5. There was a mission that was already done like this. Okay. Oh, it is not full screen. Yeah, I will change this. Why is this that made? Why is it like this? Whatever, you see enough. This OBS sometimes really annoying. I don't know, switch the resolution simply. Yeah, sometimes you have two drivable platforms, but I think it is enough to give one this choice and then it should be fine. Of course, yeah, it depends, of course, you know, both subs might spawn on a different location. Here, for example, if you check this, you have sometimes missions, yeah, how to access the screen again. You have two subs, yeah, Akula and Kilo. Could do it also for both, and then you can select both. But the screen will present you with the recommendation. As far as I know, the sub selected here will be presented you first. So you still know which one is recommended. That is quite great, but you can still have the player choice to select which sub you want. I think we already had this. Oh, here you even have a Victor, and also the choice already set. Then also has already this flex set. Okay, almost done. Yeah, pretty convenient editor. Russia's counting on me. Okay, done. Yeah, and if you check your campaign now, Halifax, you can select any sub you want. Yeah. Sure, I mean, now what are the limitations? Yeah, could be that there are some I from a educated guess, semi-educated guess, I'm not a mission editor in those games. But I checked somewhat that it did, or it should work fine. of course, you need to use your brain and keep those obvious limitations in mind. For example, if you have a if your campaign is designed for your Akula 2 and you select some 60s boat, you might have a hard time. Yeah, it could be that you can't maintain the speed in order to. In those normal campaigns, you don't have those silly objectives that often. That you can't reach your objective, your boat might be too loud, your sonars might be too weak. Yeah, or obvious thing is, of course, if you do a missile test with, I don't know, TLAMs, land attack missiles, but your boat can't carry land attack missiles, yeah, you obviously might not can complete the mission. Yeah, it's not no rocket science. And yeah, you can simply play it and either select a different sub. If I, for example, would like to play, let's say, I don't know, Alpha Class. Yeah. Or you play a US campaign where you need to launch TLAM strikes, but you want to play the Virginia Class. Yeah, the Virginia Class, which is not coming with this vertical launch system like the 688 does. Yeah, then select simply. I would for this mission simply select another boat. Period, and or skip the mission, whatever you want. Also showcase how you can skip. Where's the Virginia? I don't see it. But you are or a skipjack fan. Yeah, but you are a Virginia fan. You can play any sub you want. You can, like I said, you can also play, for example, Russian campaigns with US boat. Doesn't make that much sense, but who? You simply enjoy it, yeah. Do it, yeah. It's, nobody needs to define how you want to play. Exactly. So that's done. That's how you do it for single player missions, for campaigns. Let's see if we can fix this screen a bit. There's a solution we can do. Like this, I think. Yeah, you will see some part not of the screen, not sure what happened here, but okay. Good, next, subcommand. Subcommand is basically the same. There I wanted to do the Falkland War campaign. Exactly, and for this I want to use the Trafalgar class. I mean, it would make sense in the Falkland War to use a British sub, right? But for some reason you're using the Seawolf. And yeah, I will show you. And there's one thing. Scenarios are straightforward. I can show it you, but first we need to get into something. In subcommand, you don't have this convenience function to import campaign missions. There might be a way, I didn't see any. What you need to do is, here's for example the Falkland invasion campaign. It's consisting of this FR1 blah 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 missions, also with the same ending. You can't simply import them. So what we will do, my workaround is quickly to change MC to MU. Yeah, so they will be handled by the system like single player missions. So you can't do everything in game, as far as I know. Okay, let's get into the game. Okay, is it now full screen? No, not really. What the heck is going on? This is. Yeah, wait. So I don't know what shenanigans. OBS failed on me somehow. Let's see if it's now working. This is a joke, what? Man, it's really, come on, echt. Junge, verdammt. Yeah, okay, I get a problem. Yeah, there's whatever. I mean, you see most of the screen, that's the most important. It's not a, it is a tutorial for how to make missions, not how to how your game should fit the screen. So it's fine, and you see most of the stuff. That is important, and yeah. Good. Here, same. If you check missions, for example, I don't know, you want to play the... Yeah, for this is also activated. Yeah, you want to play some mission, I don't know, the Albany, which makes sense to play the Albany if the mission is called Albany, but yeah, you can select this up, yeah, or you have the campaign Perisher, yeah, it's already coming, and you want to play with a US sub or with a Russian sub, or you have the campaign, no, that's I shouldn't play, yeah, okay, yeah, yeah, that is, if you, if a campaign file doesn't find a mission, it freezes, because we removed those missions out of it by changing those extensions, yeah, that was bad luck, Murphy's Law, whatever, you get the idea, you can't select a sub, yeah, but you want to play a campaign with the sub you of your dreams, again, go into the mission editor, single player missions are straightforward, let's say Albany, yeah, we chose Albany as example, load Albany, the editor is quite similar, select your sub, go page 3, player has choice of platform, yeah, activate this, save, mind a backup if you need one beforehand, of course, and you can select any sub you want. So now I will modify those British missions, and as you see, here is no option to import campaign missions. There is an option for import, but I think that is something different. So that's the reason why I changed those names from MC to MU, because now you will see them in this list. You can load them. Not sure if perhaps some data gets lost, but sometimes who dares wins. First and safe. That is everything on your own risk. We're talking here about modding and like I said, but it should be, I will play it with like this and I don't expect any problems, but I can't be 100% sure. Okay. Yeah, but of course, like I said, you can think about it that if you're looking for more challenge, for example, if you want to play the US campaign with a sturgeon, why not? Yeah. But as I said, keep some stuff in mind as that those missions were designed for a specific sub. But I think Dangerous Waters is not that narrow, you know, that you most missions I've played, they can also be played with a different sub. For example, for the most missions, I don't know, you don't need the super speed of a Sea Wolf or the whatever. It is more about player. There are some missions, campaigns, for example, for Reinforce Alert that are really gripping you with some hit this waypoint in 10 seconds, hit this waypoint. But the normal most campaigns are rather open how you play it. You have something, objectives like kill a sub, yeah, kill a surface group. Avoid detection and stuff like this. So it is player choice, and yeah, if you're looking for a challenge, play it with an older boat. You can also play it with a better boat. You can play it with a boat you like. For example, in this campaign, this Falklands campaign was designed for the Seawolf, it seems. The Seawolf is one of the... It is the best submarine in the game. It's the best submarine in the world, still. The most advanced submarine. I will now open all platforms and play it with a Trafalgar. Yeah, Trafalgar is a bit older, a bit less sophisticated. Could be that it is harder, but who cares? We will simply test it out, and as a real submarine commander, you sometimes don't know what is coming for you. But I think that it's way cooler to play a Falklands campaign. I did already. I just wanted to check if it worked. To play a Falklands campaign with a British sub, of course. Can you tell me about the sub sims? I never seen them. Dangerous Waters sub command. What of these sims would you recommend? Dangerous Waters. If it is your first play, Dangerous Waters is the most sophisticated and best one. Good. Controllable sub, yeah. Player's choice. Save. Four. And yeah, of course you can, with this you can modify other stuff as well. I was sometimes thinking how to remove some annoying mission objectives that are sometimes found. For example, we played those three Russian campaigns with super annoying mission objectives. They could be beautiful missions. You play extremely interesting boats like the hotel class. Yeah, and but some of the mission objectives were absolutely ranking among some of the most annoying mission design top list of me ever encountered in a simulation. I'm not sure, but taste can differ, right? So, and taste can differ dramatically, so it's fine. But yeah, that was absolutely, and but it is not it easier. It requires some understanding how to handle goals. But for stuff like this, you don't need any editor skill here. You see, it's just hitting a check mark, pressing save. If you can't handle this, I don't know. Then, yeah. I can't help you anyways. Okay, that was it. That was, I think, the last mission of the Falklands campaign. Yeah, FR5. Now last step, exit it. Exit the game again. Let's see if it works. It's also the first time I do it. I do it sometimes. Let's do it live. Yeah, I simply raise theories and then I go to the presentation and see if it works out. But yeah, most times it should. Okay, and then you change the extensions back to MC. So the campaign is calling them. Let's see if it works out. Yeah, no, normally people would test it 10 times before going to the live stream, but I think it's rather more funny to see if it works out. Yeah. Not more, yeah, and I'm pretty sure it will work out. Simply be optimistic. Let's go. Okay, campaign, Falkland invasion, select any sub you want. Works. And yeah, as I said, the standard sub that is defined by the... I don't know why not more campaigns do it like this. Isn't that cool? Especially those SCX, SCU or RR campaigns. You can write it into the mission description, I don't know. Made specifically for the Seawolf. But goddammit, let the player select anything he wants. It's always this... I don't know, sometimes you have some hand-holding that is... But okay. Yeah, you see that the standard sub is the Connecticut Seawolf. That is what the campaign was originally designed for. But now you can select... And I installed the British Trafalgar class. Here. Let's select the... Tireless, that's a cool name. I mean, this thing can fire everything, T-lamps, should be ready for any mission. And the Seawolf also has now vertical launch tubes, so it should be fine. I mean, it is basically, it is slower, of course, not that, but the British can handle it. The British can handle it. Give me some harpoons here. And what is it? Yeah, that is fine. Wait, 5-4. Give me tiger fish, give me one spearfish. Good, let's go. Yeah, see, everything seems to work. And here you are, British submarine in the Falklands War. That's how I will play it. Seawolf. British wolf. Okay, that's it. That was a tutorial on how to get all your subs you desire for single missions and for campaigns. See you.